And here we are again, and we're going to do a painting, as you can see on the top of there, of Arthur Castle. So for starters, we've got to draw a horizon line and then fit the castle in, and the rest will come along quietly. But we'll have to draw the castle in to start with. So I hope you like this painting. I don't think it'll be finished today, it's going to take a while, but it'll be worth seeing. Thank you. First thing is create the frame. So what I've done is I've put blue masking tape all around you. It's about an inch and a half in from the top, and squared it off, make sure it looks reasonable, and from there we can now start to draw the castle and everything else inside. I hope you like it. As you can see from this, I've drawn the castle in, but I'm not going to draw in the trees or anything. I just did a bit of the foreground because we've got to get some lines. This is all done with a ruler. Any ruler will do. Ruler, pencil. So it's all you got to do with a ruler and pencil, and away you go. So I've done that. Next bit now is to start doing the filling in, the background colour that you see there. It's not going to be that. It's going to be the trees in the background above. So that's going to be quite dark, and then we're going to fill over the top of it then with the lighter trees to make it look good, and of course the foreground. Don't know if I'm going to do the castle first or last. It's anybody's choice really. It's just that we'll see. I may do the castle first. I don't care, you know, either way it should come out all right. And of course the great thing about acrylics is they're easy to adjust if you get it wrong. All right, I hope you enjoy it. That's what we're doing. Thank you. Here we are. As you can see, I'm filling in the background. I've got some green, I've got some yellow ochre, some black. That's all I'm doing is dabbing on. Alright, so this is the way to do it. Just dab it on, and I'm filling in the dark colour in the background to make sure that we got plenty of dark colour there to put the other trees over the top, which I'll show you how to do. You could do it with several different brushes really, but one of the favourite ones to use would be a fan brush, very much like this. And that would be handy to use because that would get all the tree effects that you can see up there. So let's see how we go. Let me see if I can get all the background in, and we'll go from there. Thank you. And here we are again. We've made a good start on it. I've filled in that background. It's just any old colours. There's a bit of green, there's a bit of yellow, all different colours in there. I've put the lighter colour here for the grass. I've put a bit of the tarmac in there, you know, and the road going down. And of course the shadows coming across from these trees over this side over here. So yes, a lot more to do. Can't do the foreground that covers the castle, like the little tree that comes over there, or the trees on the side, because obviously you've got to do the castle first before you can add those on. So I think it's coming along quite nice. It's going to take a while, so bear with me. All right? Hope you're enjoying it. Thank you. Well, it's starting to come together, as you can see. I think I've got the trees in the background, right, and I've got the front, but just needs smartening up and touching up here and there. It's only dabbed on, that's all. Just using various different colours, because of course there's loads of different colours in the trees. You've got to highlight where the sun is coming from, which is on from the right. So, you know, it's just a matter of getting them all reasonable and looking okay, because the focus should be on the castle. Okay? Right, see you later. And here we are, another day. And still a beautiful day, as you can see. Beautiful blue sky out here. There we are. Still continuing with the painting that we started. Now, let me go over here so I can see it. There we go. Yes, so you can see from this that we have got the painting ready. Just showing you a little bit of the garden as well while we're at it. There we go, some beautiful colours here. There we are, I hope you like the garden. As you can see, it's not much to the garden, it's just small, but it's lovely. Now, I've got the table ready. You can see the painting there. I've got the table ready here. Got some paints out. And of course, we've got all the bits we need. Got to set all the brushes in. We've got water in my in the setter there, and of course we've got some paper towel, so that's a good start. Over this side here, coming past some of the plants again, oops, let me just turn down, and as you can see, there's my little box full of tricks there, with lots of different things in there which I can use. That's very handy. So what can we say? All we can say is that I'll show you how to do one or two trees, and we'll concentrate on the castle, because that's really what we're painting here, is the castle. So we'll be here and running in 5 minutes. Hope you like it so far. It's looking quite nice. I think that I'm quite happy with that so far. I don't want to overdo it, so we'll see where we go. See you in a minute. Right then, well, here we go again, and we're going to be putting some colour on the castle now. What you've got to remember is that it's made of stone, and stone comes in various different colours, but the castle stone is a sort of a, it's like a, there's a white in it, there's black in it, and there's rose sienna in it. These type of colours are all going to be in there, so mostly white, but the colour will be there. So once we start painting the castle, this is what will happen, alright? So as you can see, all we're going to be doing is filling in everything apart from the windows. Now you can use a smaller brush if you want. I've used these type of brushes, which is quite good. It's pretty flat and it does a job. So yeah, the most important thing is not to go over too much of everything else. Even though the best thing about acrylics is that it will allow you to do it. So what we're doing now, we're putting colour on. Now it's just sort of like, as I say, it's very much like greyish beige colour. And the reason for that is that the castle is that colour. And of course it changes with whatever light that goes on it too. So the light on this one is coming from the right hand side, so the light, it's going to be lighter on this side here than it is on the other side. Don't worry about going too far. If you go over a bit, you can come back over with some dark colour later, but try not to go over the windows, because the windows I want to keep as they are, because it took me a bit of time to draw these things. So there we are, so it's coming, there we are. So you can see that's what I'm having to do. And of course, not only are there, everything's got to be painted. I'm not too much worried about detail at the moment. I just want to cover the castle, because I just want it to look tidy. So that's why I'm doing it like this. Now, if you've got any tiny amounts of detail you need to put in it or anything, don't worry about that, because that can come as we go along, you know? So, yes. Like this side bear now, really it should be quite dark bear. If you look at the photograph, it's dark that side, light that side. But it's all we're doing is we're putting the colour on, and then we shall do the other bits and pieces later. So, there we go. Some things are darker, some things are lighter. If you get the colour on you, it serves as a starting point. So there we are. You can see from this. And the good thing about having these sort of brushes is that they will do fine work as well, as you can see. So there we are. This is going to be it, I think. There we are, as you can see. Just take your time with it, don't rush it, it's pointless. There we are, so we get that done. If you're going over a little bit, but then don't worry about it too much. When we highlight in the windows, it'll come out. So there we are. You can see now how that is done. What I'll be doing next is I shall be doing that all the way across there. We'll see how it comes out. See you later. Okay. Right, so as you can see, I filled it all in mostly. I've left the windows, your windows there, but some of them are dark. But as you can see from this, the whole of the castle now is filled in. So most of the painting is filled. So that's all we need to do now is to do the detail. So I've used the brush, I've gone downward strokes with nearly everything to make sure that I cover the front to make it look good. Now the detail has to be put in. And the detail comes from the photograph up here. So if you can see the photograph up there, I don't know if you can, I'll pull this forward slightly. There we are. Can you see the photograph up there? So that's got all the shadows and the colours in it. So that's what I have to do next. So I hope that you're liking it so far. And when it's finished, it should look similar. But I don't want it to look fantastically similar. It's got to look like a painting. So let's see how it comes out. As you can see, we've come a bit further. You know, I've been using little small brushes and things to use on this. I've got one here, which I use at the moment, which is quite good. This one. See that one by there? Yeah, well, that one is great because you can do the castle with this one quite easily. Now we use a bit of white, a little bit of brown, a little bit of black together, and you can make up whatever colour you want. Now the best thing about this is that if you make it too dark, you can always, like that's quite dark at the moment, but I can put a lighter sort of tone over it later. But at the moment, I'm just concentrating on sort of creating this effect on these. So what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to make these a bit lighter. As you can see, I've put the colour on here, which is great. Because in the front here, the sun is coming from the right hand side over here, so as it comes from that side it's hitting things, and it's trees bare as well, so that's where you get in a bit of shadow here and there. And if I think it's too dark, I just have to lighten it up. So we'll see what happens. Now I'm just going to get a bit of colour on you for a moment. That's all I want to do. Yeah, it's quite light. Now if you want to really lighten it up, a little bit of white with a little bit of this yellow ochre, and away you go. You can really sort of lighten it up then. See, there we go. The same way, if you think it's too dark, put a bit of water with it and add it in. Yeah, that's right. Don't look so bad then. There we are, it's a bit better. It's up to you really what you want to do, but with me this is what I tend to do, is just to like lighten it up a little bit or so. Because it can be quite dark, and we don't want it too dark. I want it to look as if it's quite nice. And there we are, see, so you can see it's darker there, and it's lightening this side up here. Now, as I've done with the other windows, but there, I need to lighten these up, so I need to put, no, I don't need to lighten them up, I want to put the shadow on there, so, there we are, so I'm going to go into the dark colour here, a bit of black, a little bit of this brown again, there we are, make sure I've got enough water on, yeah, but you don't want it to run, yeah, it'll run on this, so I'm just going to sort of like make these a little bit darker in here. So you can see it for yourself. Here we go. It's got to be dark enough to run. So, there we are, that's much better now. Because it's dark coming from the other side, try and keep it as straight as you can. There we go. With a good little brush, you can definitely do it. You know, it's not a problem with a good brush. As you say, gonna give it a go. So look at this. It's a bit better. I'm gonna put a bit lighter in that now, so I'm gonna go to this now. Put a bit of light in it. Go. So not all shadow and dark, see. So a bit in here as well. Just brings it out a little bit more, and that's what we want really, to bring it out. And it looks nice, it sets it off. So, a little bit more of the colour now, and I might make the silver a little bit lighter on this. Get a bit. If it goes too dry, you've got to add a little bit of water to it, you have to, you're not going to get anywhere unless you do. And I'm going to make it, clean the brush off. There we are, clean the brush off, and then just go into pure white or something. And lighten that up, put a little bit of brown with it. There we go, see? So it's just a little, there's not pure white in anything really when it comes to, not even plants are pure white. So, there we are, you can see that, it's a bit better. A little bit as well, it's going to be a bit up here. That's it. Moving here, that's a helicopter over there. There was a few Chinook helicopters over here the other night, and God, they made a row. Must have been doing some exercises up in Brecon, but it was quite a racket with them, I know that much. And it was like 2 o'clock in the morning as well. 2 o'clock in the morning, huh? Keeping us all awake. What could you say? I suppose they got a train. They have no choice, same as us. You got to train when you're doing things. There we are. That looks a bit better now, see? So there we have it. You could just bring it all back to life, just a little bit. There we go. So as you can see, there we are, the turrets up there are done. Obviously there's bits and pieces I haven't done yet, but I'll get on with them shortly now, and see how we go. Don't forget, you know, you've got to lighten it up here and there. So I want a bit of white and a little bit of brown together. But what I'm going to do is I'll lighten this up a bit more. See you? There we are. That's a reflection of it there. And so there we are. It looks a bit better when it's lit up. Well, as you can see, just over the top of there as well, the window, and a little bit down the sides, there we are. So it looks that little bit more, comes to life that little bit more. Right, carry on now, and once I've done all the way across here, we'll start on, well, trying to complete the painting. But it has taken me a couple of days so far, so we'll see how far we can go with it. Okay, thanks. As you can see, the painting is coming along. Definitely more than half done now, and it looks quite good. So it's probably a little bit more now on this side now to cover that up, make it look more realistic. I think we've caught the essence of the castle, so I think it's come out really well. I hope you're liking it. Thank you. Right, as you can see, painting is completed, and I think it looks absolutely stunning. I hope you agree with me. Next thing to do now is to sign it, and then paint the frame around, and take the blue masking tape off, so that we can see then a finished painting. It's taken me longer than I thought. It's taken me a couple of weeks, really. But the reason for that is because I've had COVID-19, so I haven't been well for a while. So yes, I'm fine now, no problems. Still a little bit of a cough, but way past the time we needed to isolate. But there we are. So let's see what you can do when you isolate. You can paint. Well, I hope you like it, and I'll come back in a minute just to show you the frame. Okay? Thank you. Bye. And here we are with the final product. This is the finished article. I've signed it, added a couple of people, bits and pieces, just to bring it to life. And I thought, well, you like this. Now the reveal, you've got to take the tape off now, so let's have a look. There's bound to be a bit of bleed within the painting, that's to be expected, and we'll adjust them, but I just want to see how it looks when it's all done, and it's looking good. Yeah. There we are. Oh, look at that. I am very happy. And that's it. I'm very happy with this painting. It really did come out absolutely stunning. One of my favourites over the years. I like it. It's got a little bit of bleed there, but we can fix that with a little bit of paint. It needs something on the back of it now, and that's it. All done. One of the best paintings I've done in a long time. I hope you liked it. Sorry I couldn't take you through everything on it, but there was an awful lot of noise going on around you, and I'm afraid you wouldn't have heard me anyway. So there we are. It's a beautiful painting. It took me a long time, but I think it came out really, really nice. Thank you.